I hadn't downloaded this. Or did it go over? Well, it force pushed it. Had a reboot. It forced it. Forced reboot, forced everything. But what was it? So during that, is that when that got on there? I'll watch it later.
This new strategy.
Shoot the stickers out.
Never embarrassed.
Goodness. What if Fort Lauderdale?
Well, I know where you ought to be. When you're facing what he's drinking, are you thinking?
Yo!
Notices to the people who might be based in Wisconsin and they have to reapply for their jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
So soundly, and you look so beautiful, I just couldn't wake you up.
I'm not beautiful. I'm sleepy, and I look awful.
Not to me. You don't. You look more beautiful every day.
Not really.
Of course you do. Oh, I'll try to get home early tonight. The Hotchkisses and the Tates are coming for dinner, and I'm looking forward to them seeing my beautiful wife. I'll see you tonight.
The most gullible of all. Mother. What do you mean, gullible? You're getting more and more human every day, Samantha.
Thank you.
The way you lap up that treacle, it's just pathetic.
Well, I may not be appealing to you, Mother, but Darren thinks I'm beautiful. He's not telling the truth, and you know it. Thank you, Mother. You do say the nicest things.
Human beings can't get along without lying to each other. If they're forced to tell the truth, it's instant chaos.
That's not true. Nonsense. They're all the same. Every one of them. Including your precious dumb kid.
That's enough, Mother.
Very well, dear.
You'll see.
We saw a lot leopard, because it was a Def Leppard other than the audition piece. There you go, on your home of classic rock, it's Kate.
All right, Agatha. Here it is, Endora. I'm so glad I had one in stock for you. These little truth cards are hard to find. I knew if anyone would have it in her shop, you would. Nobody seems to be making them anymore. There's a lot of handwork goes into them, and this new generation of witches just doesn't have the patience. Where shall I put it? How powerful is it? Oh, not terribly, really. It is very old, you know. But if a human comes within 3 feet of it, he'll just have to say what's on his mind. Oh, splendid! And may I see it, Agatha? Of course.
Whatever your morning sounds like, make
your basis. Oh, it's a dear little thing.
Or a multivitamin to get kidney.
Put it on the desk, Agatha.
We take care of you, so you can take on your day.
One more thing.
Nature Made.
They do know what they're saying, don't they? Oh, yes. And Samantha won't be affected by it, will she? Not at all. She's still one of us, isn't she? Of course. Now, would you like a gift card to go with it? Oh, yes.
We help thousands of customers make the biggest purchase of their lives.
Thank you, Agatha.
The last thing you're thinking about is testing the water heater, crawling around in the crawl space.
If I'm not prying too much, what did you put on the card? Oh, just thought you might be interested in this, Uncle Herbert. It's an uncle of Samantha's husband who travels around the world a lot. I'd rather my son-in-law didn't know it was from me. Remember, if he doesn't like it, you can always exchange it for something else. Oh, thank you, Agatha.
I'll call him right away, Miss Thatcher.
Yes, sir.
Miss Thatcher, how did this package get on my desk?
Well, I don't know, sir. I hadn't noticed it before. According to
a news release, my Uncle Herbert's full of surprises. Oh, he always says, that sure is a tight dress you're wearing.
Your uncle always says that?
And I second the thought. Wow, that dress looks like it was sprayed on.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, sir. That is a tight dress is what that is.
Well, I'm sorry if I'm wearing something inappropriate.
Inappropriate? Oh, no, not at all, Miss Thatcher. That's a very charming dress. I shouldn't have been so personal.
Well, I don't mind your being personal, Mr. Stevens. To tell you the truth, I wore this dress especially for you. I hoped it would get to you. It's 2 sizes too small, and I thought it would be nice for you to notice that I was a woman. Just once.
Miss Thatcher.
I was just kidding. Really, I don't know what made me say that.
Yes, well, that makes us even.
I'll take that invoice.
I wish you would.
Mr. Stevens' office. Oh, well, just a moment, Mr. Burke. I'll see if he's in. Mr. Burke wants to know if you've done anything on his advertising campaign.
I haven't done a thing. I'd better tell him I had the chicken pox or something. Hello, Mr. Burke. How are you? No, I haven't. Not a darn thing. No, Mr. Burke. I haven't forgotten about you. Just I've been snowed under with other things. To tell you the truth, I haven't been able to work up any enthusiasm for your product. Now, look, Mr. Burke, we have a lot more important clients than you, and... The same to you, buddy. Sorehead.
Am I mistaken, or did you just throw an account out the window?
Yeah, I did, and it's about time, too.
What's the matter with you, Darren?
An account's an account. But there are some that just aren't worth it, and this is one of them. And what's more, you knew it when you gave it to me.
That's very unfair, Darren.
It's the truth. I wanted the Hotchkiss account. I know how to sell that dishwasher of his. And besides, a raise should go along with it.
What's bugging you this morning, Darren? I gave you the Burke account because I thought it was a challenge. And I want no part of it. It's a miserable man, a marginal product, and I have no intention of knocking myself out. And you can should stop making goo-goo eyes at the Hotchkiss account. Because it's mine. All mine. Right, Larry? Sure. I hope you'll be in a better mood when we come over to your house tonight with Mr. Hotchkiss and his wife. Yeah, I'll try to be a good boy. Well, see you tonight at 7, Darren. I'm looking forward to it, Larry.
Did, mister. You went through a red light.
That light turned yellow just as I was going through the intersection.
It was red all the way through.
It was yellow and you knew it. Come on now, tell the truth.
May I see your driver's license? Yeah, it was yellow, all right. Yeah, you got me.
What did you flag me down for?
Oh, I was feeling lousy and I just felt like I had to hang one on somebody. Makes me feel better when I get this way.
Do you get this way often?
You would too. I've got two enemies who are trying to destroy my natural good nature. My sergeant by day and my wife by night.
They're trying to keep people from killing one another, and all you get in return is a nasty look for all your trouble.
Gee, mister, you really understand. You know, you don't meet up with your kind very often.
Well, I don't feel this way very often. Now, would you mind removing yourself from my car? I'd like to go home.
Okay, buddy. But don't go through that light again or I'll throw the book at you.
Myself today.
Oh, you're wrong. You're very much yourself today.
Exactly. What is that supposed to mean?
Hi there.
Hi, darling.
What kind of a kiss is that?
Well, a cautious kiss. I didn't want to roll her in the eye.
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. But I had to do my hair for tonight. You don't mind, do you?
Sure I do. All men do. If women only realize how ridiculous and unfeminine they look, all that hardware in their hair.
You want me to look pretty, don't you?
Well, look at it this way. How would you feel if I came tripping down the stairs with shaving cream all over my face and offered you my forehead to kiss?
Aaron.
Well, I wouldn't be at my most attractive, would I?
No. And you're not right now.
I find his honesty very refreshing, Samantha.
Well, thank you, Mom.
Well, if the sight of me is so distressing, I'll go back upstairs.
Oh, Sam, sweetheart, darling, you are the one woman in the world who can get away with it. Even if you tried, you couldn't be not beautiful.
Oh, my. That's the sweetest, whitest little lie I ever heard.
All right, Mother, that'll do.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, that's from Uncle Herbert. It arrived at the office today. You should have seen the dress my secretary was wearing today.
Oh. You couldn't keep your eyes off her, I suppose.
Well, it wasn't easy. Of course, you can't compare with Sam. Miss Thatcher's. Well, you take her out of that dress and... Is everything set for dinner?
Yes. Oh, darling.
Don't let a little thing like that bother you. You know how men are with their secretaries.
Now, wait a minute.
Oh, why don't you two go on upstairs and get dressed? I hope you have a lovely evening.
Oh, thank you, dear.
Don't worry about about your mother. I'll find something to eat someplace.
Okay, fine.
By myself somewhere. Maybe I won't bother. When I'm alone, I just don't have an appetite.
Why don't you stay and have dinner with us?
Oh, darling, that's very nice of you. Are you sure that I won't be in the way?
No, of course not. The Tates love seeing you, don't they, darling?
Oh, yes, yes, they really, certainly, really, really, really do.
Don't overdo it, dear.
At 7 o'clock, Samantha. Yes, 7 o'clock.
So I looked that man straight in the eye and I said, sir, give me a chance to prove to you that a 6-year-old boy can handle that toughest paper route in town. He did, and I did, and that's how I got my start.
Ed, that's a wonderful, heartwarming story.
It is.
Isn't it, Darren?
Certainly is, Larry. Respect, Miss Hotchkiss.
Oh, thank you.
Come on, have one while you're there.
Stevens, that's a mighty cute wife you got there. Maybe she could help us write a few slogans for my dishwasher.
I'm afraid I'm not very good at that sort of thing.
Yes, it does take a little talent, doesn't it? Larry, that reminds me. I thought of a great slogan for my dishwasher today. Let's have it for nothing.
Great, Ed. Let's hear it.
Everybody ready? Nice.
You're absolutely right, Ed.
I am sending it, Ed.
What was the slogan, Mr. Hotchkiss?
Well, this is going to kill you. Here's how it goes. Confucius say, don't be wishy-washy, buy a Hotchkiss dishy-washy.
Hey, that's great, Ed. Darren, make a note of that and we'll discuss it at the meeting tomorrow.
Yeah, sure. Sure, Larry. Yes, sir. Yeah. I won't have to make a note of that because I won't forget it.
How can I forget anything as ridiculous as that? What was that you said?
Wishy-washy, dishy-washy, you must be kidding, Ed.
Now, Darren, you've got to admit that it's pretty catchy.
Don't get nervous, Larry. I know Hotchkiss is a pet of yours.
That's right, buddy boy. And if anybody's going to laugh at a pet client of mine, it's going to be me.
Larry, don't tease Mr. Hotchkiss. They always do this with a new client. It's a sort of fraternity initiation. Junior high school
fraternity. You must lose a lot of clients that way.
Oh, no, we only do it to clients who have a good sense of humor. Yeah, like you, Ed.
You, Ed. Yeah. Well, that's one thing you can say about me without fear of contradiction. Right, Francis?
Whatever you say, Ed.
A sense of humor has always been an important ingredient in my success. I've always been able to laugh at misfortune, even during the grim days when I was pulling myself up the ladder. Rung by rung, I worked myself up into the appliance business until...
Knock it off, Ed.
What did you say, Francis?
You didn't work your way into the appliance business. You were kicked into it by my father, who gave you $25,000 when we got married.
How can you say a thing like that?
It's very easy. It's the truth. Darren, I have had it.
You put those drinks.
I don't know, but I'm willing to give you odds. We never make it to dinner.
Now,
Francis, take it easy. Get them both barrels, honey. You'll feel better.
Louise!
You know, I've been clamming up for years while he's been playing I Love Me on his big trombone. And don't you ever snap your fingers at me again.